Hey everyone, I'm Silver, and today people, today we are on a super flat Minecraft world, and yeah, so I wanted to play some Minecraft and show off some amazing stuff I could build in creative, and I'm sorry, I haven't been active really this past week. I've been super busy with work and school. And just really haven't had the time to record a video. So with that being said, let's get right into it. So for the first canning, it's going to be simple. Most of the stuff you can also use repetitively for all these cannings. So first off, you need a bucket of water. Then next, I'd recommend a stone block. Then you're going to want to find slabs. Come into the redstone, where all the important things are. We'll need a lever, this for later, some redstone, dispensers, and the most important, TNT. So all these tools can be used multiple times to build multiple TNT cannons. If you're a factions player, then you'll use these quite a bit. So to start off, let's build the basis of the cannon. We'll build it a little bit higher off the ground, just like you would in factions. We'll make it a single block high. Doot, 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 doot. I can't remember exactly how wide this will be, and I'm going to test out some cannons, some things I've seen. So, to start off with, we need to make this 5 wide, in total, I believe, if I remember correctly. Okay, next. We'll just place this down as markers for ourselves as of right now. This is going to be the muzzle of your gun, or your TNT cannon. This is where everything's going to fly out. So next, you're going to want to put a slab there. And a dispenser here. And you're going to want to put a stone block. Or, if you really want to get fancy, but we'll show you fancy later. A stone block there for now. And a bucket of water so it flows. So see, now that it's flowing, you can put a brick of TNT there. And it flows. And because it's in water, it's not going to cause any block damage. So, I'll show you the still sending power. Never mind. One second. So, I'll show you the most basic of cannings. So, put a lever there. Load this up with a whole bunch of TNT. There you go. You're going to want to put this here. Now, this is one of the most basic cannons. Flip that. Wait a couple seconds. And flip this crazily. You're going to take some damage from this. Uh-oh, I blew up the cannon by mistake. Oh, I got lucky. I only blew up part of the cannon. Cool. So this, again, is an easy fix. I could even just throw a slab here and call it even. Oh, nope. Slab there and call it even. So, again, I want to put this there, pull that, and then pull that a couple times. And it shoots the TNT. Super basic. But this can be very inefficient. I mean, look it. You're not getting a lot of range. So how can we make this better? We'll block off the water source. We'll remove the power source. And remove that power source just in case. So the water is going to stay, but I just shut it off for now. So I can put in the automated system. Oop, don't want that facing that way. There we go. And with some redstone, we now have automated our cannons. And just because I'm lazy and I don't want to set continuously do this later on. And there we go. We replaced the bucket of water. And to make it even more convenient for you, we'll put this there, this there. We'll do this, this, this. Run this along here. Put the lever here. Now you can stand back, flip this lever, and then flip this lever a bunch of times. And look at that! The TNT went much farther this time, even hitting those pigs. So again, here, let's set up a little platform for us to stand and watch on from here. And there you go. Okay, so what you do, shut this off, turn this on, and you come here, flick this a whole bunch of times, and watch as the TNT flies. Some of it limps forward, yes, but look at the distance on that. Now granted, this is okay, but you want to take it up a notch. Oh, well, there goes that block. Nope, we don't want it like that. We want it like this. And then we'll block off the water source for now because I gotta re-edit it. Now, I wouldn't advise this cannon because this means you gotta do more work for this one. If you're lazy and you don't want to do work, this is not the cannon for you. So you're not gonna want this path anymore. You're going to want to extend your platform by an additional block now. Now this is getting more and more advanced into cannoning. And I'm not even, I don't play a lot of factions. I see a lot of YouTubers play factions, so I sort of know the whole ordeal when it comes to setting up a cannon. And I don't think this will link, right? Oh, I might have just blown up my cannon. Okay, well. Good news is, I only blew up the front part again. Gotta stop doing that. Oh yeah, and you can also, yeah, by elevating the block, it works better. Okay, so now that we've done that, nope. Now that we've done that, let's reload all these new ones with more TNT. There we go. Now, the process is the same. Bucket of water, that, and then you spam this, and look at that, TNT flies even farther, just in case. You can even do this two times and do this, so, whoop. Look at that, farther. Now this is pretty straight. There's a couple ways to like modify the cannon in the sense that you can build up over it, so you can choose how far it shoots, so this will shoot a different path. So it's sort of angling the cannon. See? And bam, since it has to go forward now. And you can only do this so many ways from Sunday before it doesn't work anymore. You can slightly adjust and then spam. And then it's because it's hitting this block up here that changes the angle. You can raise it an additional block. I don't think this really does much at this point by doing this. I mean, if you do this, maybe. And then you do this. Yeah, see? Oop. Yeah, it doesn't really go far. But that's okay. This is great. Now you have a moat. Good job, guys. Okay. Moving on to the next cannon. This one's not too complicated. If I remember it correctly, it's built like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Boop, 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 boop. I believe it's 3 long. And it uses dispensers as the back wall. Now, this is going off memory, so don't, you know, skewer me if I get this wrong. Okay. Oh, nope. Not what I wanted to do. Okay. And then we want to build. Oh, nope, not what I wanted to do. That. And then this. Okay, now the water's just getting on my nerves. There we go. We'll put the water back in after. I want to do this, 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 nope, and this. And this one's going to be completely automated, meaning that it will shoot itself. I believe you put the water in here. Yep. Make sure it's all even. Oh, don't want to do that. Although you could. There we go. Okay. So how does this one work? Well, again, it works like the other cannons previous to it. Gonna wanna load it up full of TNT. And I'm not kidding, that's quite literally all most of these cans will ever do. Just load them up full of TNT. Now again, this one I'm basing off memory. 1 second / time set day. So don't skewer me alive if I do this wrong. I'm also experimenting here with some of these cannons. Whoop. So I don't entirely know. Don't know if certain cannons will only work in certain versions. So this is a learning experience, and I wish I would stop hitting shift before I needed to. Okay. So how this works is you're going to want to build a repeater system. Nope. Using the repeaters we pulled out earlier, set them to the farthest take points. You're going to want to loop them. Make sure the loop works. You can break the loop. And then you're going to want to come up here, shift the redstone on top of all of this. And when you're ready, you're going to want to connect it, give it like 2-ish seconds, and then you're going to want to connect the top part and watch the automated system work. So we'll start, and now we only have so much time to do this. See? Well, the cannon blew itself up. At least no one can track your cannon. That's the most important part. Because I done messed up. But that's okay. There's a couple other cannons. So, like I said, I'm still experimenting. This is one of my more favorite cannons anyways. All my faction friends that are watching, like Seed, are probably cringing right now. But that's okay. Because I personally like doing this cannon. So you're going to want to do this, this, and then you're just going to want to build one straight wall. Actually, no, you're not even going to want to build the wall. Just fill up the center. Center works. This is a suicide cannon. The worst this can do is not work. So you're going to want to put a bunch of repeaters down. Boop. Get a few strands back. And pull the lever. That's what we call Gatler. Uses minimal resources in the sense of you barely use any of your stone and stuff, but you're going to waste a lot. And then there's some people's favorite, mine included. If you can break into, and again, this works if you're playing factions. If you break into someone's base and you claim enough land in it, you can completely demolish it after stealing all their stuff. And do this. Okay, so that's, what, 3 long. We need one more. Now, this works if you're just really, really want to be evil. I call this death. What you do? Simple. Set up repeaters all the way around it just to make sure you get every single outside layer covered. Doot doot. Doot doot. And then you're just going to go around the entire outside, line up the TNT. This will definitely get you to waste your resources of redstone. But if you are, again, raiding bases, you might be able to afford it. If you don't play factions, this is just fun to troll people with. Okay. The trap has been set. So what you want to do, imagine this is behind a wall. You're going to want one other item. Let's find it. This. So say this is all behind a wall. What you're going to do is you're going to make a line. Now this will be deep inside the wall, and you can be evil and set it up throughout the entire wall to encompass the whole base if you claim it all. And we're actually going to break that connection real quickly. and say this redstone is the most valuable piece of this stack of redstone is the most valuable thing in the server. You leave this connected, and it's behind a wall. We'll just make a mini wall. Let's just say this is the wall. For whatever reason, they're not questioning why there's this hole in the wall. They're not questioning anything. All they're like, hey, look it. I need to check if my valuable thing is still alive. That's odd. That should work. Oh, there we go. I forgot about the repeater. Anyways, huh, what was that? Oh, well. Oh, God! Napalm. And then, every faction jerk's favorite. Get a little glide, and just line the base with TNT. If you really are really into TNT, just line everything you can find with TNT. I mean, every square inch. Just say this is an entire base. We'll put down some chests to make it look convincing. Well, I mean, if you want to be that guy. Now, why is this important, you may ask? Well, now you've done the important part. You've lined the entire base with TNT. You've claimed the land, so you can build in there. So no one suspects that what you're doing is evil, and probably you're one of the most hated people on the planet. So, last but not least, get out of here, slime. Last but not least, you want to do the most evil thing you can think of. Line every square inch of their floor in pressure plates. So when they log back on, come back in, no matter what it is, wherever they are, whether it walks through right through the front door, or it's, you know, logging back on from having dinner with the family. You just really want to mess this guy's day up. I don't know what he did to you, I just set it all off. But essentially, you line the whole thing up, and when he logs back in, walks in through his front door, he realizes he pissed off the wrong guy in factions, and now his base has been obliterated. Well, you keep all of his delicious, delicious butter. But yes, so our most successful cannon today survived. So with that being said, let's blow the thing up. It is Minecraft after all. So say you find someone's TNT cannon just cause they were a noob and failed at life. I don't know why they left the cannon lying around, but hey, they left a cannon lying around. So, stuff happens, and just cause I'm evil, we're just gonna wind the whole thing up with TNT. I mean, you know, this also could probably work in your favor if you just wanna feel like you're being pressured and you're gonna commit and you're gonna end up dying cause, I don't know, some enemy faction is after you. I'm talking a lot about factions, and I don't even play factions. I know a lot of people play factions, and that's where you see this type of stuff. Maybe you just wanna blow stuff up cause you're sick and evil and I don't know, because it's fun to blow stuff up. I guess I'm just as sick and evil as the rest of you. So you can do this. This is a good option. Just surround your nearest TNT cannon in TNT. And oh, wait, there we go. Just surround it. Just keep piling as much TNT as you can have. See, when I did play factions, I always had TNT of all varieties. Nuclear, explosive. I was demolition guy. I made sure nothing survived when we raided it. And I was good at my job. Some people would say it was my true calling. I mean, we really don't need this on there. That works as well. And there you go. Okay. Almost there. Just want to make sure it's all nice and covered. Make sure we've encompassed everything that could possibly need a douse over of TNT. And there we go. We call this explodey. Explodey does things that nothing should ever do. Make it nice and evenly squared out to get the most blast effect radius. Like this. We'll layer this one more layer. We'll break that off because we don't need it. Okay. And slash time set day. There you go. Explodey. Explodey's ready for its trip to, I don't know, wherever Explodey goes. Now look at that. You're going to get the most blast radius and just cause the most explosive damage. Yeah, there's nothing else to it. All this damage can be done with, I don't know, like 5-10 stacks of TNT. No, because we're evil and probably sadistic. And because I firmly believe that every little cult deserves its life destroyed. We are going to push you back in. Oh, wow. Okay. You got beef, bro? I got beef, too. Nope. Get back in there. There we go. And we're going to want to replace that. And just because I'm evil, because you grew up at the last second. Look at that population. I wonder how many cults there are. Because I'm really evil. Oh. Okay. Well, fine. Actually, we'll make it easy for him. We'll let him decide where to go. Come here, little horsey. We're going to decide on something. We're going to go this way and walk into that pressure point. If you don't move... Oh! Well, night, horsies. And we get a survivor! So what we're going to do now is perfect. You've walked into trap numero uno. He suffocated. Wow, the stuff got dark, guys. Okay. Before this gets too much longer, I've just enjoyed blowing everything up. We're just... I'll be right back. I got one last. And we're back. We are at build height 256. The highest you can build in Minecraft. Fun fact, TNT blocks fall 70 blocks a second. I wonder how long it'll take for it to get down here. Huh. I wonder what... Holy crap! Ah! Run! Run! Ah! Follow it. The death and carnage of all the... of this entire land. That was fun. Now if we follow back this way, there's a village! Guess what we're doing to the village. This one guy in particular. He's just minding his own business. See, I've learned a trick. You don't want to box them in right away. Because then they catch on. You. You good, sir. You wait there. We want to level your living space. Some. No, I don't want to trade. Can't you see? I am destructive and evil and... You guys are about to have no place to live. You might want to... start selling, because this is what I was originally looking for, and I can't believe I missed it. So we'll just line this up, line that up, some of this. This looks important. Come down in here. I hope you guys don't have children. We'll just fill. Well, this will be known as Test Villet Test Home 3. I used to love doing this back when I just played Minecraft for fun. Stop trading! You broke the straw of the camel's back. Yeah, you run! You better run! I'll be back for you. Your water fountains won't survive. Your gardens aren't surviving. Nothing you guys have is surviving. Nothing at all. Nope. Not a thing. I really should go to bed because I'm tired. But the best ideas come to me when I'm bored, so this is not one of them. This was a TNT episode, and now it's... Well, I mean, it was a TNT cannon episode, not just a random TNT episode. But hey, explosives are fun, right? At least I believe they're fun. At least that's what Minecraft tells me. Okay. How much damage can you do? I wonder, how many stacks of TNT would it actually take to blow up an entire village in Minecraft? Or if you were just to transform every block in a village, in a normal spawned Minecraft village, what would be the odds of it turning, how many blocks would it take? That should blow that up. We'll loop back around and layer the roof of this. The underside. I want to make sure we're not missing a thing. Slash. Time set day. There we go. Ah, perfect. Hey, you friend. Go right there. There we go. Well, nope. Fine. Go over here. Just as bad over here. It's just this time. I know what I'm doing. Nope. We'll put. Fine, you know what? We'll box you in like that. Do that. And, haha! Gotcha! Now what are you gonna do? Call for your friends, I dare ya. You're not getting out of this. Anytime soon. Haha. Okay. It doesn't look like we really got a lot on the ground level going on here, so we'll cover this up. You know, remember, this is all for factions. I have no idea what I'm doing anymore. If you stayed this long in the video, please leave a like and subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want more random weird stuff like this, because I do a lot of this. Actually, I think one of my first Minecraft videos was just testing out TNT. And yeah, okay, now let's see here in a second. I think that's almost every building covered in some way or another. We'll fill up the inside of this because I know this is slightly spacious, as long as I don't touch that. There we go. And we'll make this guy responsible for his entire people's death. Hey, buddy. Can you come here for a second and just step on this? That, we'll just layer a couple around. Just make it a couple people's fault. We don't want to leave one guy out all by himself. You know. Come on, buddy. Here. I'll help you. Oh, that's right. Forgot the most important part. There we go. Die, village! Well, at least you guys have one home left to live in. There was a village here. I don't know. But guys, that will be it. I really enjoyed making this. If you guys enjoyed watching this half-hour TNT special palooza of me being sorry and not around on YouTube as much as late, hit the like button, sink your fangs into that subscribe button, and remember, Silver Wolf Pack, until next time, keep it nice.